In this episode of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you how to customize effects and save presets and instruments in GarageBand. We showed you in an earlier video that you add an effect to a track by selecting the track, clicking the Track Info button, and then clicking the Edit tab to reveal the various effects you can use on the track. Most effects will have a series of presets from which you can select by clicking the Preset pop-up menu located under the Effect Type pop-up menu. Often these presets will get you close to the sound you're trying to achieve, but you can also further customize most presets by clicking on the icon to the left of the pop-up menus, which will reveal the effect's controls if it has any. The noise gate, for instance, does not have any controls besides its amount slider. After you modify the effect's settings, you can save it as a preset for use on other tracks or in other projects, typically as a starting point to tweak as needed for any particular recording. Click the pop-up menu in the effect palette and choose Make Preset. Enter a name and it will be available in the preset's pop-up menus. Additionally, once you've tweaked all the effects for a track, you can save that combination as an instrument. Click the Save Instrument button, enter a name, and then this mixture of effects and their settings will be available from the Browse tab for use in any other track or on any other project. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel for new Minute GarageBand videos each and every week. So long!
Johnny looks at his teacher and says, "Wrecked him. Damn near killed him."